you?
Good morning, Agent Morgan. I'm the Extension Fairy.
Extension Fairy? I didn't know we had an Extension Fairy.
That's right. North Carolina Cooperative Extension is using every resource possible to empower people and provide solutions. So here I am. Tell me, Agent Morgan, what's your greatest wish as an Extension agent?
As an Extension agent, I wish we had a way to show people how to take samples properly and bring them into us so we can help diagnose the problem so they can get an efficient answer to their problems.
What a wise Extension agent you are, Agent Morgan. As you wish. When looking at your field for insect or disease problems, first take a look at the whole field. Look for patterns. Do you see yellow plants? Do you see damage in a particular area? When inspecting a plant, be sure to check out the entire plant, including the root area and where the plant stem meets the soil. Don't forget to check the undersides of leaves because many of your pests will be lurking there. When investigating a problem to bring to your Extension agent, take some notes. Is the damage throughout the entire plant, on the extremities, at the base?
When we're taking a sample, it's best to take a whole plant, roots and all, with some soil around the roots. We're going to put the roots and the soil in a plastic bag and seal that off to keep the soil from getting on the foliage. And then after that, we're going to put it in a paper bag. This allows the plant to breathe and keeps the sample from deteriorating.
If bringing in an ornamental with an insect or disease problem, be sure to bring in a substantial portion of the plant for successful diagnosis. One leaf is usually not helpful. If you can bring in an actual example of the insect that's giving you problems, it's so much easier for your agent to make a quick and accurate identification of your pest. If you take a sample early in the morning or right after you've irrigated, you might want to lightly pat it dry before you bag it for sending to your agent. That way, no introduced pathogens that are not part of your original problem are introduced into your sample.
If you can't get the sample to your agent the same day, put it in the refrigerator to help preserve it.
If further research is needed, your agent will help you prepare the proper form to send to the correct agency. So in conclusion, in preparing an insect or disease sample for your agent to properly evaluate, remember to get a whole plant with soil if appropriate. Take notes on the symptoms and distribution of the problem in your field. If appropriate, remember to get an actual insect or a photo of the one that's bothering you. Preserve your sample by making sure it's not exposed to extremes in temperature. And if necessary, we'll package your sample for further analysis by the appropriate lab. By following these simple steps, you can help Agent Morgan's dream become a reality.
Extension Fairy? When do we get an Extension Fairy?